It's a shocking statistic. 32,000 Indigenous adults could go blind within the next decade due to treatable eye conditions. Now, multi-award winning artist and actress Christine Arnoux is using her voice to help save people's sight. She has joined forces with the Fred Hollows Foundation and Specsavers to launch the Langaliki Project, an initiative raising funds to close the widening health gap in our communities. Tara Callinan has more.
Christine Arnoux knows all too well about the harsh reality of poor eye health in First Nations peoples. It struck frighteningly close to home, hitting her nearest and dearest.
Diabetes is prevalent in my family, and along with diabetes comes a lot of the vision, you know, the eye health as well. And my mum was suffering from cataracts, and she just thought that the use of her eyes, it was, you know, her time was up. But I took her to a doctor and she had the laser treatment done and now she sees perfectly.
You know, to be able to get Aboriginal people to have an eye check, a regular eye check, is a really important thing.
Sight restoring cataract surgery performed by the Fred Hollows Foundation can cost as little as $25 in some countries. That's why $25 from the sale of these limited edition sunglasses will be donated to the Fred Hollows Foundation, which is hoping to give $100,000 to Indigenous communities.
Everywhere you go in Aboriginal communities, there's some great work being done, and that's where they are the ones, the community, have to decide, and the people who work in those community health centres are the ones who have to decide what's the greatest need. So that's where the funding will go.
The $25 from both the special edition frames that will go to the Fred Hollows Foundation will be for the raising of the awareness of what Indigenous people don't know about eye health. It's up there with treating, you know, blood cholesterol levels and kidney issues and your liver issues, that people need to go and get their eyes tested. Without your eyes, your world closes in. And when people got to go out and work and you're at home because you can't see, who's going to look after you?
Last year, the Fred Hollows Foundation spent $62,000 on a trachoma elimination program in the Top End. But Christine hopes this year's focus will be on prevention and education.
People don't know this, but it's really got to do with your hygiene and how clean your hands are, and, you know, when you go to wipe your face. And children weren't taught this when I was growing up.
Tara Callinan, NITV News.